Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on KXLF. I'm Kevin Stanfield. Well, one man is in custody today, suspected of robbing and beating to death a 64-year-old Anaconda woman. MTN's John Amy tells us about the manhunt that led to the suspect's capture in Butte.
Anaconda police suspect 52-year-old Troy Johnson bludgeoned to death 64-year-old Shelley Schaefer during a robbery in her East Park Street residence sometime late Monday or early Tuesday. Johnson was finally arrested Wednesday morning in Butte after a long manhunt.
Just tragedy, you know, I hate to see anything like this happen, especially in a small town.
Investigators suspect Troy Johnson was living right next to the victim's residence in this part of the duplex, which had no utilities such as power or running water.
There was a bed made there, and Troy Johnson's driver's license was left inside there. We found a jewelry box just outside the back door there. After talking to witnesses, and we felt we had enough to get a arrest warrant.
On Wednesday, police in Butte conducted a traffic stop on Montana Street in Butte, where Johnson was a passenger. The female driver got out of the car, and Johnson drove away with the vehicle before crashing at Holmes Avenue and Hanson Road.
He exited the vehicle. Our officer that was first on scene believed he was pointing a weapon at him. Our officer fired multiple rounds at the suspect, who was able to escape off on foot.
The manhunt continued for the next 4 hours. That included help from a helicopter.
They were searching as well as our canine, and one of our officers was able to spot this guy just off of Little Basin Creek Road.
The manhunt finally came to an end here in a field off of Little Basin Creek Road, where police say Johnson lunged at officers with a knife and had to be subdued with a taser. Sheriff Ed Lester said he's convinced Johnson had no intention of surrendering peacefully.
In my opinion, I think he probably wanted to end it in a hail of gunfire from the police, and realistically, he damn near got his wish.
Johnson is expected to be charged with deliberate homicide in Anaconda and could face charges in Butte as well. In Butte, John Amy, MTN News.
The State Department of Criminal Investigation is also assisting in this case because, as John mentioned, a Butte police officer fired his gun during that arrest. Johnson remains in the Butte jail this evening.